Hello lovely viewers, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll take you through an interesting request from one of my subscribers. So it reads, "Hello sir, I have been trying to do this assignment but I don't understand how I supposed to start. Please help me out, please. I like coding and I don't understand. This project requires students to develop a mobile application using B4A in pairs. The project ensures application development consists of the following: a database with appropriate attributes which define the details of your proposed application. 2. A search feature to search for records. 3. The add, update and delete buttons. And 4. Display all records in the repository. Students can use the sliding menu, text fields, multiple pages, image views, panels, labels and buttons to design the app's user interface." So this is what we have from Jessica Lau 5548 about a month ago. Sorry, I didn't see this early, but I will take you through the procedure of designing it. And then for database, we'll be using external database. If you don't have it, you can go to DB browser, sqlitebrowser.org, and you download this database software. I have my own, so let me fire it up. Okay, so I want to do it as a class, kind of a class registration or student membership kind of app. So let's create our database. So to do that, we click on new database. You can use SQL library to also create the internal database through the app, but this one I want to use the external database method, so you see how it's done. Okay, so I'll name it membership.db. You can name it .sql. These are the extensions you can use. I'm saving it to desktop. Now we have to create our table. Let's call it table members, TBL members. Okay, now let's add some of the fields. First let's add primary key, ID as a primary key. Let's make it auto increment. Then we add F name for first name. Let's make it a text field. Let's add L name as last name as also text field. Let's add position also a test field. Maybe the person is the school prefect, dorm prefect. If the person is holding any position, let's also cater for that. Let's also look at the person's age. The age, we leave it as integer. Let's add gender. Let's also make it a text field. And then status, you can add status so that the person is active or inactive. Let's also make it a text field. Lastly, let's add date added, also a text field. Now that we have our database ready, we click OK. Good. Then click write changes so that the database will take effect. I usually like to add DB version for version control. So version as integer. Okay, so the DB version, this one is not really necessary, but you can add it. DB version, insert one record here. I'll make it one. Now that the database is set, you can close it for now. Now let's create a new project. I'll be using before X pages. For X pages, I'll call it class membership. Okay, our database and our project is ready. First things first, I'll go to main. I also name it the project class members version 1.0. and code title false. We'll be adding a splash screen, so we don't want the title page to be shown. Okay, now that we are here, now let's look at designing our UI. Next, we'll fire up our emulator. So, okay, let's check connection. Okay, it's connected. Good. So, first we have a splash screen to use the main page as a splash screen. Let's do that. With this, first let's reduce animation to 0, right? And then we remove the title. To remove the title bar here, we'll delete this button. We'll add an image view. The background, let's make it white. The image view, let's expand it a bit. It's width and height 160 by 160. Let's write a script to center it all the time. Image view dot horizontal center 50% x dot vertical center 50% y. So when you check, you see that it's always be in the middle. When I move it here and I run this script, I should always put it in the middle. Let's add image. I have some image assets here. Let me add it to these images. Cut. I'll add it to the project. Shared model. Since we're using before X pages, I'll paste them here. Rename this one as splash. So if B for A or that project in the asset file, you're not seeing anything, but because we're using B for X pages, after adding the items to the shared model, you come and you click here, control click on this, and to copy all the files to the individual asset folder. So now if you check before, if asset folder is there. So next we go back to the designer, add file. So let's select this, and then in the image view, the image file property, we'll add the splash. Because it's not square, let's also expand it to be a little horizontal. Good, there you go. Now that we have our splash screen, let's create another layout. I usually use LY to start my layout. So file LY dashboard . This is our dashboard. For the dashboard, I want to add panels. I'll use one panel as the title bar. Mind you, here I'm not using show title, that's why on the page you can't see title. If I click show title, you see that the title bar will come, but I'm not using the show title, so I'll create my own title bar. So I make it 60 in height. Good. Which color scheme should I use? For now, I'll use my color picker. Okay, let me pick this color. So, dark blue. Okay. On this panel, I'll name it panel heading. I'll add a label inside it, and I'll expand it and anchor it to both sides. The text will be centered. Will be white in color. Then the text will be dashboard. Good. And then beneath, I want to add the features. It also will be in panel or issues label. Okay, let's use a panel. It's a label. This is the first panel. I'll anchor it to both sides, and I'll use the light green blue color. Sorry. So I'll copy this color. Change one. Let's use a button. Expand it a bit. And the color will be state list. The color will be the light blue. Color will be. Radius will be 10. Let's see. Let's make it. The current radius to be 20. Same will apply to the crest. Crest color. Let's make it deep blue. 20. Okay. And the text will be add new right. Let's name this button add. I'll duplicate this button. Record this one. Button update. So we'll change the text to update, and then I'll duplicate this one again. We'll call this one button delete. Looking at this, I think I'll have to restructure the app. I'll place the buttons at the bottom, right? Then I'll add a list view here, which will list all the students as soon as you come to the dashboard. The buttons, I'll anchor them to the bottom. Good. So I'll use custom list view. With that, we have to add XUI views and XUI library. Now that we've added these two libraries, let's go to the designer now and go to add. Under custom view, you see custom list view. Let's add it here. Expand it, anchor it at all the sides. Okay. The buttons, let me reduce their height a bit. and then the anchor at both sides, we only anchor it at one side. Then we can resize them. This one should be anchored to the right, this one left, and this one will be in between. We can make them in between, the one in the middle, to be stretching. Or since the ad will be used most, let's put the ad rather in the middle and anchor it at both sides. And the update will be here. Good. So now that we have the app is taking shape, what's next? I want us to create a card at the top. The idea is always changing. I want us to create a card at the top of a panel so that the selected user details will appear there. Okay, so let's put a panel here, anchor it to both sides. Then I think the background should be a bit gray, so let's make it F5. Good. You can see a big difference. The panel, let's give it an elevation of, let's say, 2-3. Good. Let's give it a rounded corners. Also 10. Good. Let's expand it a bit and reduce the custom list view. Let's name the custom list view CLV. The CLV, you can also, let's select it as an elevation. It doesn't have elevation. So what you can do is we duplicate this panel. Anchor it up, down, left and right. Then we place the custom list view inside. So the custom list view will have the elevation everything from the panel. Okay. Good. The panel I created, we'll put labels here which will show the person's full name. So should be black. Duplicate. Duplicate. We shift them to this side. They will contain the information. So according to both sides. Let's rename this one. There you go. Name. Set for this UI. I think the next UI we should create is I think everything will be done here. When you click delete, when you click the user, it should display the person's details here. When you click delete, it should delete. When you click add, okay, it should add a different page. We can have a dialogue, but for the sake of this, yeah, we are allowed to create multiple pages. So let's create another layout for adding user. Okay, so file, let's save this one. File, save as ny add. So layout add. So the title, we'll name it add new user. So delete this, and this. At the top, we can add this same label. We'll only anchor it to the left. Delete the text. Since we are doing our own menu, we have to handle the back, press everything. We change the interface to material icon. In that material icon, we look for arrow. Let's take the back arrow, paste it here. Let's increase the size to like 25. Good. So then let's add the fields. Add new. Let's add before it floats the float text field. Let's anchor to both sides. This one should be text first name, F name, hint. Should be first name. Duplicate this. I have first name and last name. Duplicate. Age. The position, I want us to have a predefined position, so we'll add a combo box. U for X combo box for position. Position, and also the same for gender. Okay, so CMB position, CMB gender. Good. This one be test first name, test their name, and him to be last name. So be text age. the status and the date added, which we did in the database. Now we will handle it from the code, so we will not add it here. Let's stretch this using anchor. We can add a label to show what we are doing here, so we can add a label here. A label should show what the person needs to do. So text position, text should be black so I can show, and then duplicate, Ctrl D. Here should be age. Good. So this is gender, and then button add, stretch it, we'll anchor it, we know the button anchor so I can close. We'll name this one button save, and the text will be save. Good. This label for the arrow, let's call it label back. I think the update should also come here. The update will also use this same label, this same layout, but yes, for now let's leave it like that. Okay, now that we have the label, the layout, let's go to the activities, change to debug. Let's add two new activities. One will be project add new module, class module, before X page. I'll add it to parent module because I intend it to be cross platform. Maybe I may change it to before G or before I. So let's add it to a parent module. Let's call this one at add. So it will be the add page. So this is the splash screen. This page, let's declare the activity here, the add page. We say private, this is dim page add as add page add dot initialize before x page dot show page, sorry, add page id add, this is small d, page add. Good. So it says this page will be the splash screen, which is showing the image. We want to show it for some few minutes. So after declaring this, let's say sleep 3000 for 3 seconds, then before x pages or show page, page id, which is id add. So we'll show the splash screen for 3 seconds, and then we'll move to the add page. Okay, so I forgot one page, which is the dashboard add new module before x page at dashboard. That's where the buttons and the list view is. So we have to, so from here I think we should rather move to the add dashboard. So let's do the same thing for it here. Page dashboard as at dashboard. Let's initialize it as well. So let's copy these two. Page dashboard dot initialize, then add page id. Let's call it, just call it dash page dashboard. So id dash, so it moves to the dashboard, right? So this is the dashboard. The dashboard Let's load the layout. LY dashboard. Right. Let me go to the dashboard layout. Dashboard. Good. Let's declare some of the items on the page. List view should be declared. Let's say list view item click. Let's also activate it. Then label name, position, gender, age. Let's also declare them. Select all. That's B4X view. Generate members. These buttons, let's also declare them as before XP. We can just use the click event. Okay, let's just use their click event. We don't need to declare them since we'll not be changing their properties. So generate members. So we have the activities here. Good. Let's also go to the add layout and do the same. Root dot load layout. LY add. We have the label back. Declares before XV. Okay, we'll back click. Let's do a click event. Text. Let's declare them. Generate members. Button save. Click event for button save. Combo boxes. Let's also generate them. Select. Good. I think this one to is set. Okay, with this we are set. Let's end this and then we'll continue from part two with the coding aspect. Thank you for watching. Thank you.